Welcome to BC Mac. Today I'm going to start a new series about FreeNAS, how you can install it on your VMware. So let's do it. First of all, let's just go ahead and open the website to download the FreeNAS image. So for that, I'm going to open my Firefox. And from here, this is the website, FreeNAS. I'm opening it. You can also just type FreeNAS and it will open the link for you, or you can just go ahead and go to Google and type FreeNAS and you will find the first website, that is freenas.org. You can visit the website from here, or you can directly download by clicking on download FreeNAS. So it's right here. You can fill the details or just click on no thank you, send me to the download page. When we click on it, it will take us right here. So this stable image is currently stable release. You can download it from here. It has a new web interface. If you want to go with the legacy web interface, you can download the 11.1 from here. So I have already downloaded the image. Let me just take you to the image. Close these windows and open the VirtualBox. Now the VirtualBox is up. I have already installed a FreeNAS onto it. And let me just delete this and show you again how to install it. Let's click on delete all files. It's done. Now click on new. Let's name it as FreeNAS. And then select the type other version unknown 64-bit. Click next. And the recommended memory used by the FreeNAS is 8 GB, so let's just provide it around 9 GB for better work. Let's just create VirtualBox disk image. Let's select the default option, dynamically allocate it, and let's just give it 4 GB of 10, around 10, and create it. So it's almost done. Let's just select the image by going into the storage option, and from here we need to select the disk, and the disk is available right here with the name FreeNAS 11.2 release. Let's click on okay. Now let's click on start to start the image. The installation will automatically begin in like now, and installation is started. You can see that it will take around 5 to 10 minutes depending upon the disk. Now we need to press the enter button to install the FreeNAS on our VMware machine. Let's click on OK. Use the space bar to select the hard disk and press OK by pressing the enter, and select yes. And now we can set up a password. Again, press the tab button, press OK. Now we'll select the default mode, boot via BIOS. As you can see, it's the recommended mode here. Let's click OK. Now it will take around 5 minutes to install the operating system. So I'll be back. Now, as you can see, the FreeNAS installation on ADA0 succeeded. Please reboot and remove the installation media. So let's press OK. And from here, just click on reboot. It's rebooting now. In between, let's go to the settings and just remove the device from here. Remove disk from, and press OK. It's done. Let's just go back to the screen, and as you can see, it will be auto boot in 4 seconds and it will be rebooted now. And we will see the configuration moving on. Now once the configuration is finished, it will show us an IP address. You need to note down that IP address. That IP address will help us to access the FreeNAS web page. It will take a moment, around like 2 to 3 minutes, to just finishing the initial configuration of FreeNAS. After that, it will not take that much of time if you restarted it again. As you can see now, the web user interface is at 10.0.2.15, but my router address is 192.168 1.1.1. So to resolve this issue, what I need to do is I need to make some changes to my network adapter. For that, I need to go back to my VirtualBox manager, and from here we need to go into settings, and then we need to go on to the network. And from here you can see it's a NAT, and we need to just go ahead and do it as change it to bridge adapter. Let's just do that and press OK. So the configuration is successfully saved here. What we need to do here, we need to just reboot our system by using these options 1, 2, 3, and 10 is the reboot option. Let's just type 10 here and hit enter. Now it asks you to confirm. Just press Y to confirm and hit enter. Now it will reboot the system, and then it will generate a new IP address for us, for our router. So let's just wait. It will take a moment to restart. As you can see, auto boot in 3 seconds. Now you can see that we have the new IP address 192.168.1.81. So let's go ahead and open the Firefox and try to access this address 1.81. 192.168.1.81, and let's just open it. And as you can see, the FreeNAS is right here. Let's go ahead and type root in the username and the password that we have created. Let's log in. If you want, you can save the password as well. And we are right here. From here, you can check for the updates. You can just click on it and it will show you the option. No updates available. And the first thing that you need to do is you need to go into the system and then go to the general, and you need to check your time zone. So it's right now America, Los Angeles. So I need to change it to my time zone to get the correct updates. So let me just take it to my country, Asia, Kolkata, and save the settings. Now just go back to dashboard. And as you can see, it's 532 right here, 533. So it's almost the same. So guys, that's it. How you can install the FreeNAS on VMware. And as you can see right here, my machine, it took it from here, Intel Core TM i7 and everything. And the memory is 9 GB. Right now I have around 16 gigs of RAM on my computer, as you can see it from here, and I provided 9 gigs to the FreeNAS. The default is 8 GB, so you can put the default one as well, no problem with that. More the RAM and it's give you the better performance. So guys, that's it from my end. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.